I'm Dietrich Klinghardt. I'm a medical doctor. I received my training in West Germany, and as a young doctor already moved to the US because I loved the United States. I passed my test here and have been licensed here since 1983. And I've been practicing here really since then. But I go regularly back to Europe to both teach there and to learn what's new over there. And so I'm being like a dual agent, you know, bringing things that I learn here back to Europe and things that I learn in Europe back to here. And I have a practice in Seattle that specializes in the treatment of chronic illness. And we sort of slowly moved up our ranks, me and the doctors that work with me. The average patient that we have has seen 23 other physicians before they've seen us. You know, so we're sort of like, if you want, like a late stage of the journey that patients are on after they've maybe failed or have given up on other treatment modalities. And so in that position, we've sort of were also forced to look deeply into the causes of illness. And the main thing that we discovered is that illness is not a static thing, that the foundational causes of illness are now quite different from what they were 30 years ago or 35 years ago or 40 years ago. I graduated in 1975 from medical school, and none of the things I've learned in medical school have prepared me for what we see now in the medical practice. I teach a lot of medical students that come through my practice, both from naturopathic schools and from traditional medical schools and osteopathic medical schools, and I am aware that the teaching in the medical schools to a large degree is lagging behind the evolution of illness. Like when I graduated from medical school, we didn't have a single lecture in those 5.5 years on chronic fatigue or on chronic pain. All the lectures were on acute pneumonia, on rare fatty acid disorders, which we never will see in our whole life as a physician. But the things that we encounter now every day, we didn't have a single lecture on. And unfortunately, that hasn't changed very much since then. So I want to just, from the beginning, kind of say from a medical perspective, you know, there's kind of two kinds of illnesses. There's the illnesses that have a name, the traditional illnesses like diabetes or hypertension. There is fractures and there's appendicitis. And then there is the much larger amount of illnesses that really go without a name, where the people feel they have lost their zest, they lost their enthusiasm, they lost their sex drive, they lost their joy, they don't dance anymore, they don't sing anymore, they're still living, but they're living sort of like a half-life. And our experience, of course, with the patients that we see is that every patient that we see is in that category. The main symptom, if I would put it in two words, is loss of zest. You know, so it's not that people are suicidal, they just have lost the vibrancy of life, the color, the smells, the excitement, the sensuality of it. And we see that everywhere where we look, we see the same picture. I visit a lot of other colleagues in other practices, both here in the US, Canada, and in Europe, and see the same picture there. And so we, over the years, tried to distill down what is it really that has changed in illness and what is causing this strange state that we're in, that we're observing worldwide. And we really were able to distill it down to just a few factors. The main one being people have increasing numbers of chronic infections. We don't see the acute pneumonia very often or the acute staph infection. Yeah, those exist. They usually end up in the hospital, and the hospitals are doing a good job with the acute stuff. But chronic infections,